The Birthday Gift by Kim Brack. Narrated by Mandy Kaplan. Chapter 1. The Strange Men. Jenny clutched at Michael's arm.
Look, she said, we're being followed.
It's the two men who were in the bookshop, Michael told her. I wonder why they're following us. The children kept on walking home, wondering what the men were doing and why they were following them. They won't follow us forever, said Michael. Let's keep walking. We won't go home just yet. We don't want to show them where we live if they don't already know. We'll see just how interested they are in us and how long they are prepared to follow us around. So the children did not go straight home. They walked around and around the town, going in and out of the shops. They twisted and turned and doubled back. They went around in circles. But still, the men followed them.
I'm getting tired, said Jenny. We've been doing this for an hour. We're not going to lose them. They're going to follow us as long as we are outside.
Let's go home and get help. We can tell Dad what's going on.
All right, agreed Michael. We'll take this shortcut. It won't take us long to get home now.
The shortcut, Michael pointed out, was a quiet back lane, and there was no one around. The two men followed Michael and Jenny down the lane, and seeing that it was quiet and deserted, they began to move closer and closer to the children. Suddenly, they grabbed hold of Michael and Jenny and started questioning them.
"Why did you buy that book?"
asked the first man. He was an ugly-looking character, with a broken nose and a scar on his left cheek.
"None of your business," Michael told him.
"Come on, kid," said the second man. He was worse than the first man, with lots of scars, and he looked really evil. "You'd better tell us. Or there'll be trouble," he told Michael, and started twisting Michael's arms.
"Leave my brother alone," Jenny yelled. "If you really want to know, we bought it as a birthday present. It's our dad's birthday on Saturday."
"Is it now?" said the first man. "Well, see here, missy. We want that book, see?"
"You're not going to get it,"
shouted Michael, and started to kick the second man, who was still holding him. This took the man by surprise, and he loosened his grip. Michael twisted around, freed himself, and jumped out of the man's reach.
"Run!"
Michael called to Jenny. He grabbed her hand, and they set off down the lane. On and on they ran, the men following them. They twisted and they turned up and down the small back lanes. The men kept following, but were soon confused in the maze of back lanes. The children knew the back lanes well, and were soon out of sight. Realizing they had lost the men, Michael called to Jenny to stop.
"We must hide the book," said Michael.
"But where? If we hide it at home, it's the first place they'll look. I'm sure they can find out where we live. If we ask our friends to look after it, they'll be in danger too."
"Why not hide it in the old deserted house in Baker Street?" suggested Jenny. "It's so big that even if they realize the book is there, those men will be searching for days."
"That's it,"
agreed Michael, and the children set off at once for Baker Street. The two men, meanwhile, were completely lost amongst the maze of the back lanes and had completely lost sight of Michael and Jenny.
"Fool," said the first man, "you couldn't even keep hold of the boy. Now they've got away with the book. Wait till the boss hears about this." "Don't worry, we'll get that book back," replied the second man. "We'll get their names, perhaps even their address, from the man at the bookshop, and then we'll pay them a visit. They don't get away that easy."
Chapter 2. The Kidnapping.
"Jenny,
Those two men are still outside, said Michael. It's 2 days now since they chased us and they are still waiting.
I know, replied Jenny. It gives me a creepy feeling being followed everywhere I go and knowing that they're always outside.
What worries me, Michael told her, is that if they keep this up, we won't be able to get the book back.
Yes, Jenny said. I think we had better get another present for Dad's birthday. Let's go out now and get it. I'm sick of being shut up in the house because of them.
Okay, Jenny. I'll get our coats and we'll go now.
The children set off to the shops, and the two men followed them. Before they had gone very far, the men caught up with the children and started questioning them again.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.